by grace, and if you didn't do nothing. All you gotta do is believe it and receive it. Grace gave you the possibility to be saved. It was in your dress, it was in when you start sleeping with. I don't know if this is the sign of it. Think I thought you had me, man. Come on, teacher, you better have me on. See, I can't put over here dead on me. So I understand that I have all these big possibilities, but apostle, they come through God's grace. Amen. So I have to understand that in order for me to walk in this, I have to first receive this grace. Amen. So when grace came, God took all the work away from me. Yeah. Because grace is his ministry. Amen. It's not a voice that any man should boast. So grace is God's influence on your heart and my heart. Grace is his influence on creation.
Yes.
Grace is God's influence on creation. The way it was just a favor. It's a favor because you can never earn it. It's a favor because you can never qualify for it. But when grace came to Jesus, God came and said, now I'm here to stay. Amen. I ain't coming to anoint nobody and go back. When Jesus came, he said, I'm here to stay. Because when Jesus can finish his work, now the Holy Ghost coming. So I'm always be here. I'm here. So I understand now that I have all these possibilities. I have the possibility of having the best relationship.
Yes.
And the best marriage.
Yes.
So how do I fulfill that possibility? I go to the book. Find out what the book tells me about relationship and marriage. And I do that. Y'all not gonna talk to me. I have the possibility to prosper. I go to the book.
Yes.
Y'all know I'm going to talk to me. See, you have to understand that faith comes by hearing.
Yes.
Hearing by God's word. So everything in these possibilities start with what? A word.
Amen.
It is a faith that it might be by grace to the end the promise might be sure to all the seed. Let me tell you something here. After you get a shout, please hear this. Write this down. After you do all the shouting you want to do, everything will happen in your life, you'll promise.
Yeah.
I know that's my partner, it's still the truth. After you dance and hoop and do all these things, anything that's going to manifest in your love in your life from heaven is going to be to a promise.
Yeah.
Promise is the way that God's transitioning things from heaven to earth. Let me say it again. Your inheritance is already reserved for you in heaven. God lets you know that it's to a promise. So that promise then become a possibility.
Yeah.
Whatever God promised you, it became a possibility.
Yeah.
Are you all saying, once you said it, it's already finished in the word of truth. It becomes a possibility for you here on this earth.
Yeah.
So anything that you want to get coming from heaven down to earth is going to come through the vehicle of promise.
Yeah.
I think I'm moving too fast. Let me talk again.
Yeah.
So that means that all times in my life, I have to be working on a promise.
Yeah.
Are we here together?
Yeah.
After all the Bible stories, if I'm going to increase, I'm going to increase to promise.
Yes.
If I'm going to get healed, I'm going to get healed to a promise. It's going to have to be something that he said to me. Because he's not going to respond to nothing outside of what he already said. I'll be here together. I'll be here together. So now I understand. Let me give you a little illustration here. Because like I said, y'all didn't go to Miami Jackson. So let me talk to you about your faith. This keyboard here. When he plays it, he plays good music. That won't be all of y'all. I can't play it either.
Amen.
But this has a purpose, right?
Yes.
But there's something that makes this work, doesn't it?
Yes.
If you plug this thing on here right now, there's no power source.
Amen.
That thing is going to work.
Amen.
I don't care how good he can pray.
Right.
I don't care how good he can play it.
Yes.
It's not going to work because it's not connected to the power source.
Amen.
Now, when I connect the power source in here, something's gonna flow from that jack into this thing, into the piano, right?
Yes.
To this chord.
Yes.
But if he shut this thing off, it's still not gonna play. Why connect it to the source?
Wow.
You're not walking in.
Wow.
And see where I'm going with it. See, I'm trying to show you something about faith and possibilities. Because the power source of your faith is the love of God.
Yeah.
But the thing that flows out of love, the thing that comes out of that wall, the electricity now, becomes grace and truth.
Yeah,
but the thing that you need to activate is your believing.
Yeah.
Lord, please help me here. Let me say it again. I know it's easy to get excited. But I'm teaching you how to walk in these possibilities. See, God, see, the Bible says faith worketh by love. So faith is plugged into the love of God. if I plug in the love of God, now what flows out from there? Yeah. What flows out from that love is grace and truth.
Yeah.
So how do I get grace and truth activated in my life? Through believing.
Yeah.
So this whole system of faith, y'all ain't talking about to me here. This whole system of faith means that I gotta believe.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Come on,
come on. Are y'all walking me here?
Yeah.
I have to have a focus of believing.
Yeah.
Because believing is how I activate my faith.
Amen.
The Bible says the spirit of your faith is you also believe, therefore
you speak.
Amen.
Now let me tell you something. It didn't say you also think and speak. It didn't say you also understand and speak.
Uh-huh.
If I had 5 minutes of pause, I would tell them that the biggest contrary to your belief is your understanding. Because
yeah.
Mo focus, I don't understand that.
Yeah.
He never said understand and believe. So he told you that there's some things that God will say to you and promise you that you don't understand. That's why you trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not to your understanding. And all your ways in God's hands, He shall direct your path. So we grow to believe in your understanding. I don't know if you ever had a conversation with somebody trying to help, and all you keep saying is, I don't understand. You're not supposed to understand, you're supposed to believe. Which means that I'm going to speak it because God said it. Heal me, but I'm gonna speak it. Because He said, I don't know how He's gonna put me out of this mess, but I'm gonna speak it. Because He said, I don't know how He's gonna fix my talents on me, but I'm gonna speak it. Because He said it. I don't understand how it's gonna happen because God works in a mysterious way. So I don't understand how you're gonna do it. I just know you said it. Glory to God and feel the Holy Ghost. So since He said it, I'm just gonna believe it. I'm just gonna believe it. I'm just gonna speak it.
Yeah.
You thought you was all that, but you still don't respect your husband. You thought you was all that, but you still